So today we are going to talk about how non-IT candidates, especially mechanical candidates, civil candidates, EIE candidates, how they can enter into IT fields and without coding knowledge. You heard it right, without coding knowledge. I'm going to talk about five sectors where you can get into that field with basic coaching or basic training, or even without basic training if you are having enough skill to crack that interview. So the first one is hardware and networking. If you ask me how can I enter into this field, I will ask you two simple questions. Do you know what are the hardware components in your PC and have you handled it properly earlier? Then that's the first point. And second point is, have you anytime installed Windows in your desktop or your laptop? And even for the second question, your answer is yes, then you can easily crack the basic or first round of any hardware interview. If you're not aware of these two questions, then you have to go for any hardware course. So basically, hardware courses will be a combined package of networking courses. So when you join for networking course, they will also will teach you hardware. So now let's talk about networking field. So networking field, it deals with routers, switches, all these things. So for learning all this stuff, you don't need heavy coding. So until and unless if you're going for Red Hat, if you just want to start as an associate in a startup or somewhere, then hardware skills are enough. But if you want to join as an associate and build your career as well, then you have to go for hardware and networking course. It's a very good career, and it also will not ask you which graduation you have done, and they will only ask you about the certifications you have done in CCNA or CCNP or MCSA or Red Hat. So here salary will be starting off around 8,000 rupees per month, but it will go till 10 LPA when you are in fourth year or in fifth year. So it is that damn career to start your journey. So the second field is tech support or BPO. Do you have good communication skills? And the second question is, can you write nice formal emails? And the third question is, do you also know some good hardware skills? Then it's very cool for you. No need of going for any courses, no need of even going for any training. Just tomorrow, just go for a technical support interview or a BPO, then just go and attend the interview. It's a very good start for you if you want to get into IT field. So basically, I will talk about the interview rounds over here. So first one is, they'll check your communication skills. So they'll ask you a couple of questions and you need to speak for a while. Either it would be in English or it would be in Hindi. So the second point is, they will test your WPM. So what is WPM? It is words per minute. So they'll give you 1 minute or 2 minutes and they will just see how many words can you type. So if you're meeting that number, for example, if they are expecting 60 words in 2 minutes, if you can make it with 100% accuracy, then that job is right for you. So if you belong to a non-IT department and want to enter into IT departments without any training, then this sector is right for you. Tomorrow itself, just go and attend. Do not just think that BPO is a small job. It's a very good job. And first associate, junior level, L1, L2 supports, and then you will finally also will go for team lead and manager. So that much career is there in that. So do not miss this sector. So the third department is graphic designing. Are you creative? Can you represent any idea into an image or nice infographic? And if you also know some skills like Photoshop, Illustrator, then this category of jobs is right for you. Even in this category, they will not ask you whether you belong to computer science or IT. If you have skills or if you have enough certifications in these departments, or even if you have some relevant experience, then these jobs are right for you. So candidates, if you don't have any of these skills, don't worry. If you can spend 2 months to 6 months, and if you can join any course which is having XD, Photoshop, Illustrator, then RMC, you can easily get a job even in graphic designing. If you also do XD, you can even start UI designing. Coming to the salary, if you take the previous, which is networking, which will be having 14,000 in hand, and BPO also will be having 8,000 to 14,000 in hand. But when you take graphic designing, starting itself, it will start from 20,000 rupees. So if you want to start with a good kickstart, even in salary and with 2 to 6 months of training, and who all want to get into into IT field, this sector is right for you. So if you already have these skills, just go to any job portal, search for graphic designing, just see the skills over there and apply. If you don't have, just go for a training. Either it could be 2 months or 6 months. Don't go for online courses for this sector, just go for offline. The way of teaching in this sector is completely different, and the way of representation of your ideas will be completely different, because you will be having couple of people who will be working on the same idea. So for example, if my friend has worked on the same idea in a different presentation and myself taking the same idea and representing in this different manner, so I can compare both at the same time and I can improve myself. So that's how offline classes will be more useful than online classes over here. So the fourth category is product sales. You can directly ask me why sales for the graduates. Like you can ask me, like, I have done my graduation in so and so and why I have to do sales. If you just take some example of Dyson or some brands, they are only looking for graduates who have done mechanical engineering. Why? Because they are selling some products where only mechanical guys can understand and who can explain to customer properly, and especially for mech, this is the brand. But there are also a lot of brands. It could be for civil, it could be for EIE guys, it could be for triple E guys, or it could be ECE guys. So there are also products. So these people are looking for grads who are specialized in those departments. So you have to explore every job portal and you have to see which brand is looking for your specialized branch graduates, and that too for product sales. It's very good for you. And the salary packages over here, it will be 20 to 30,000 rupees per month, even as a fresher. Coming to the interview part, first round, they'll ask you about your graduation stuff. And the second thing, most important thing, is communication skills. So here in this round, they'll just check your communication skills, and they will also will check how well you are writing a formal email. So all female candidates who have done mech and civil and who haven't got core job and who are looking to enter into IT field, then this department or this sector is right for you, and salary packages are also very good when you are having 3 years or 4 years of experience. So the last and important and topmost sector is medical coding. You can directly ask me a question that the word itself is having coding. I'm talking to you about the concepts where you don't want to learn coding. But don't worry. Why? Because this coding is completely different from the coding which is the programming languages which you need to learn in order to get into IT sectors, especially software engineers. This is like completely different. So what is this medical coding? Every transcript, every medicine, all these things will be having dedicated codes, and this training will be given by special training centers. So if you're getting into these training institutes, they will train you how to do this medical coding. It won't take more time. It maximum takes from 1 month to 1 year. In between, you can easily learn this. And what is a good practice or what's a good advantage of getting into this field, and that too with a training institute, is if you take all these previous four and this fifth one will be having 90% guarantee of getting into a job, that too through a training institute. Why? Because all these training institutes are being linked with some IT companies where companies do require medical coders every now and then. It's a very good career, but the salaries will be very low, like 8,000, 9,000, 10,000, 11,000, 12,000. It will be like that. But if you are doing this job for 3 years or 4 years, then it will go for 30,000, 35,000 rupees, and smoothly. If you're going for abroad, then it will go like very huge. So candidates, a lot of people don't know about this sector. Research about this medical coding. It's a very good career if you want to get into IT field. In this also, certifications are there. If you do a couple of certifications, you will be promoted. And in India itself, you can get easily 80,000 to 1 lakh in month itself. So candidates, I hope you like this video. I'll try to keep some job links which are related to these five sectors in the description. Just go there and apply today. So all the best guys, try to explore about these five sectors more deep and then start your career. So all the best guys, we are coming up with much more interesting videos for you. Do like the video and subscribe to our channel. Thank you so much.